Today. Start with the torso rotations, and then work to a head to knee pose balance.
Warrior three.
Little warrior three to half moon. Cool new push-ups. And then Al sits on the wall, putting our feet on the wall to lift. So that could be a cool way to get some core strength for handstands, okay? I didn't even tell anybody I was going live. So I'm just going to put music on and go. This light is weird. I'm sorry. I don't know what to do about it. I keep hoping to get to the studio and be able to do a workout there. So hopefully soon. And I'm going to start, all right? I have a new soundtrack too. So have water because I think it will get a little heart rate going. Okay, right. So torso rotations. You start with your feet hip width apart, okay? And you go in a squat. You come up and rotate to the right, the left. For me, I'm rotating to the right, okay? Come back to the center, breathe out. Rotate and reach now. Back to the center, reach. Nice, back down and reach. So let's kind of do it to the beat. Come down, come up, hold for 2 seconds and repeat 5 times each side. Right, so it's down, two, breathe out. Come back center, squat as low as you can, push. And as you're pushing, really push and reach, push down with this opposite leg, so you're really engaging this whole side. So it's a stretch and a strengthen. Push, reach, down. Come up, open, breathe. Four, reach, down. We have five, and then we're gonna go five with a leg lift. And breathe. This back arm, by the way, is doing work. See my back arm? I'm twisted, but you're pushing. I'm like, my palm is flexed. I'm pushing down against the ground, right? So breathe. Nice. Now come down to a squat. For the next five, you can come down, touch the ground if you really want to get your heart going, okay? Your heart rate up. It's down. When you come up, kick your leg and then down. We're going to stay on that side for five and then switch. So it's down, come up, down, up, down, up, down. One more, and we'll go to the other side. Down and kick. So can you hear the music? Breathe, it's down. One more. Nice, good. Come down to the ground and come up. Just reach overhead for five. Squat down, up. Now everything is active. You're coming up, you're squeezing your butt, tucking your pelvis, lifting from the belly button, pushing your arms together, okay? It's not soft, it's engaged. Now the next one we're gonna do, I'm gonna try to pick a song and do one move to it. The next one is, the rotation is you're gonna squat, rotate, step in. Squat, step in. So down, a little faster. Make sure you're squatting well. Breathe, reach, rotate. See this? Watch. Look at the shape. I'm squeezing my obliques, squeezing my groin together, my abs. Down, one more. The other side here. Rotate, step, reach. Rotate, step, reach. Down. Push. Push. See it? Feels good. It's nice. It's squeezed. Yeah, yeah. Whew. Breathe. Right? Got that? So, torso rotation. Nice. Torso rotation with a leg left. And torso rotation with a step in. It's cool. Nice. Reach your hands around behind. Make a fist. Breathe out. Remember that breath of fire? Squeeze all the air out when you breathe. The in does it on its own. The very core. Okay, it's breathe out. Squeeze the abs. All right, so breathe in. Give me 5 breath of fires. Breathe in, breathe out. 2. When you relax, your lungs fill. 3. A little weird, but feel all of that. And then 4. All right, balance. We're going to go right to a balance, okay? So, start with the basic. What I'm trying to do is head to knee pose. But we're going to come down, right? This is what I want you to do is this. Okay. Like that. Doesn't even have to be pretty. It just has to be feel good. But start by mountain pose. Come down, grab your knee, and come up. Now, correct, grab your knee, right? The weight's equal. This butt is active. Lift onto the tippy toe of the leg that's going to be moving. Right there, I start rolling to the outside of this foot. It means I'm not using my adductor muscles. So activate them. Squeeze the butt. Bring your body back into posture. Extend the standing leg. All right, you can do a pelvic tuck just a little bit and then give me length with the belly button. Then come to a straight leg, lower. Go right to the other side, down, and try to go for the ankle this time. Breathe in and breathe out. If you're having a hard time with the balance, stop, engage the muscles, right? And if you want to challenge yourself, gaze shift while you're doing this. Look around, breathe, don't squeeze with your toes. Nice. Then down. Good. Do it again. Come up. Breathe. Grab either your knee, under the knee, calf. Woo! That's actually harder than just coming and grabbing your toe. Now try to use the same arm, same hand, and grab the big toe. Whoa, and don't fall. Go the other side. We're just working on those. So you can come right down, right, and grab the toe. You don't have to come up straight legged. You can come up crouched, squeeze, stay crouched, still just maintain the alignment, maintain the activation of all the muscles you want. Go, straighten the bottom leg. Nice. Actually, even if you just work on this, keep it with the knee bent, be like dead bug kind of, right? Straighten one leg. And then come to extension. Breathe. If that's tight, grab the ankle. And if you can't, come up, if you're having a hard time, grab under the knee. Extend the standing leg. Get length. Breathe. Nice. Come up. Breathe in, breathe out. Give me a roll down. Tuck your chin and roll. 2, 3, 4. Breathe out, come up. Reach up and around, up and around. Gorgeous, nice. All right, so right leg is the leg that I'm moving. My left leg is standing leg, okay? I'm gonna go down and grab my big toe. I'll go sideways with my middle and my pointer finger. I'm gonna come up with my knee bent because I kind of like that transition. Like a dead bug, so my knees externally rotating, my heels up in the groin, right? And I'm really opening my hip. Now I'm gonna come right in front of me, not changing my posture, breathe. Hold, 1, 2, okay? Move it a little bit, nice. Come back, good, and then come down. Beautiful. Breathe in and breathe out. Reach your arms around and behind. Open your chest. Relax all those muscles you just tensed. Nice. Give me a little back bend. Oh. And then round forward all the way to the ground. Nose to your knee. Straighten your legs. Shake out all your tension. Breathe in. Roll it up. I'm going to go now. Left leg's the one. Come down, give a flat back forward. If it's tight, bend your knees. All right, if you're having a hard time balance, hold on to something. And come up. Whew, nice. Reclined, happy baby. Breathe, 2. Now come to extension. It should get easier, breathe. If you want a challenge, we'll do a balance challenge right now. Nice, good, come down. And reach overhead, arms around. We're not going to roll down. We're going to roll down. Actually, we are going to roll, but we're going to go down. Right to grab. Reach down and grab the right leg. With your pointer, your middle finger, your right knee, your right ankle, your right toe. Big toe, baby toe, bottom of your foot. Come up. Knees bent, hold, 1002. Now come out in front, full extension. Now do a gaze shift and look over your left hand. And then open your leg to the right. Breathe. Come back to center, especially when you go to fall. Play a little bit with dancer pose. And then come high knee, back to the center. Breathe in, reach your arms around and behind. Just let all that air out, all that tension out. Breathe. Back bend, just for a release. To back bend to get a nice psoas release. Squeeze your butt, squeeze the butt cheeks. And just let that arc happen right up and through here, mid thoracic region. Nice. Now come down. Go right to grab. Now this time, if you want, you can come right up a straight leg. Okay? There's another, a different balance challenge. Straighten the standing leg. Watch your alignment. And then open your leg to the left as you look to the right. Hold 1002. Nice, good. Whoops. I was just thinking if that was a yoga, like if we're doing traditional yoga here, you're holding that sometimes up to 30 seconds, 90 seconds. It's a very challenging pose. Breathe in and breathe out. Nice. So now let's just do a head to knee real quick. I talked about it and we didn't do it. We did a couple each side. You'd be surprised how much you feel this. So come down. All right. I flat back. I'm going to come up. Breathe out. Then I'm going to grab my ankles. Whoa. Sorry. No falling. Grab the ankle. All right. Straighten your leg. Standing leg and get the extended leg as close as you can, and then you pull your nose to your knee. Ooh, sorry, balance. We'll do the other side, just go the other side, shake it off. Right, so here, nice. I'm down, I'm gonna come up, extended leg, breathe. Up, find it, breathe. And grab ankle, foot, knee. Ooh, straighten up. Work on that balance, and then pull that in. Nice, right? See that? You could even actually, don't even worry about the ankles. Just get used to this motion, this balance, this pendulum movement with this leg balancing and stabilizing. Allowing one leg, this motion. Our body doesn't mind this, the pelvis. Right, so right there. Now right there, if you're bending your bottom leg, extend it. If you're hunking your shoulders, hiking your shoulders, relax them. Breathe. You could even breathe. You could even come here with the knee bent and then round your nose to your knee, then come out. Okay? So try that too. Breathe. Extend. Nice. Whew. Getting that thigh right to the belly, right? Releasing and contracting what you need to. That's work. Extend and round, okay. Ooh, that isn't as pretty. Breathe in. Oh, and breathe out. And reach. Nice. So come one more little flat back forward. Let your arms fall as far overhead as they can, right? Get your body weight a little more forward. And then round your nose in as close as you can. Come to a nice flat back. And breathe. All right. Now, I'm going to grab a water. And let's do a warrior series, okay? So it's this. I'm going to step back. I'm going to open. I'm going to go warrior two. And then reverse warrior, come forward, half moon. Breathe. Good. And then up, high knee down. Right? 5 times that side. So warrior two. So cues in warrior two. I don't care how deep you go in. What I care about is where this knee is and that it's a sink. All right? A lot of the time you see it's of this. And that's not what I'm doing today. It's a sink. Down, down, sink. Watch, I'll release my groin. My back foot, hopefully you can see it. That's where I'm gonna get my length, okay? If I'm doing this with my shoulders, my arm is gonna stay on my hips to help remind them they need to stay forward. The knee, watch when we bend. Make sure you can see the first 3 toes of this foot, all right? So it's warrior two, breathe. Now if you wanna play with warrior two, you can bring the torso back, all right, or forward. It's the torso you play with this flow, not the hips or the knees. Then hips, down, up, okay? Warrior two, your arms are active and engaged. I have a tendency to bend them, so really push out at your elbows. Extend the elbows like a quad set. We do an elbow set. Breathe. And drop your back hand, turn front palm up. We'll reverse that, warrior. So right here, all right, lat, oblique. See that right there, psoas, a little bit of the QL. Make sure as you reach back, this knee isn't rolling in. Be meticulous with these knees, protect your knee. Activate the glutes and the surrounding muscles. Then a half moon, right, see this? See where nothing changes. My upper body doing all the motion, so a lot of strength with mobility. So then now, half moon. So half moon, first, come forward with both your hands on the ground. You want the standing leg at full extension. You want your hips not only stacked, so you gotta really roll open, but open, both legs are at full extension. You're contracting your quads and releasing the hammy. And then if you can, you don't even have to gaze shift. Just take the front hand, the opposite hand of the leg in front, right? Breathe. Then rotate and stack the shoulder. And then come up and you keep your hand on the ground and breathe. Do a little mini back bend, okay? Ready? We have 3 more. So step back, it's warrior two. Breathe, reverse, two, forward and breathe. Open and down and then up, back bend, breathe, swing your arms down, and as they come front, open, warrior two. Now let's increase the hold just to change the intensity for 4, 3, 2, 1. Drop the back hand, give me a reach as far back as you can, get to full extension, and then count 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then come forward and reach as far in front of the foot as you can for half moon and go into whatever phase of it that you can. The most difficult component of it initially. Find your balance. Open. Breathe. And then hold. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now come back. Center, do a little mini squat, or even as deep of a squat, cobbler, and then up. Wow, my legs are tired feeling this. We have 2 more, too. Reach your arms around and behind. Breathe out. Nice, step open. Warrior two, three. We'll hold it 1 more time for 4 seconds. Reverse it. Lift, get even deeper. 2, 1, come up for half moon. Now just to throw this at you, if you want to add a little more of a challenge, you can come in and crunch and open for the count of how long we were holding. So we were holding for 4, and so come in for the 4. And instead of stepping into the middle, step back, warrior two. It's kind of a cool transition, and breathe. Reach. So last one. Get as much as you can here. Nice.
then forward, come up. I'm gonna put both hands down on half moon and just really work on moving my body back a little bit and getting a little deeper into my right leg, my standing leg hamstring. See that subtle, be careful, but just find that, breathe. Nice, now come down. And then you're just gonna go up to the center and breathe in, breathe out. Awesome, flat back forward just for a stretch. And then come up, hip forward. And flat back forward again. You can bend your knees and drop your body, knees, torso open. Now I'm gonna do that this side, so open. When I transition, I like to lift the toe up and use the heel as I rotate. Because literally you're rotating your hip in your socket. So we want the right amount of torque, I guess would be the word. You want your fulcrum at a certain, you don't want it in the toes and this force to come from there. You want it to come from here, okay? So anytime you rotate, do it on the toes. I mean on the heel, on the toes, on the heel, sorry. Okay, warrior two, find it. If you have to heel toe, sink, find, reach, breathe. Now watch that hiking of that shoulder, okay?
Yeah.
Looking over and through your thumb would be where you were looking at the target if you were gonna shoot. Breathe, two, reach back, one, get a lot of extension, sink down into reverse warrior as you reach back. Nice, now come through to half moon and transition, having the door right here for me, messes with me, believe it or not. Open those hips, work on those hips. Beautiful, I'm not gonna step down, I'm gonna go right back to warrior. You can step in the middle into a little squat and then step back. It's actually just as much work, just different work. Hold, two, let's do a four count. Three and four. Rotate palm up and reach. Breathe, two. We'll stay through four for this whole thing, how's that? And then come forward, half moon. I have to move back, I'm sorry there. Now I can do it, it's weird having that. Guess that's a good calmness in a stressful situation. Breathe, two, three, four. Nice. Warrior two. Three, sink right there a little bit. Down and back, two. You could increment it too. Breathe and come up, beautiful, and hold. I'm gonna do abs, four, three, and two. Go one, nice. Back, come up, ooh. One, two, three, four, reach, two, three, four, up and around, breathe. Now for this ab, I'm gonna come up and I'm just gonna lower my leg in and down, right, see that? Be surprised how much this gets your glutes. Good, nice, breathe. If your head is hooking like mine, don't do so close against the wall. This is the last one, four. Sometimes if I'm really pushing active yoga, I'll go down, up, two, three. This is my cardio yoga. All right, so then it's one, two, three, breathe. Two, so I'm just throwing this at you, just to know. The different ways you can take this flow throughout the day and make it right here as challenging. You could even do upper, okay? That's like a standing half moon. Breathe, one more. Whew, I'm gonna call it there, okay? Nice. Nice, okay, so we're gonna go down to the ground and I'm gonna do
walkouts, kind of, for my push-ups, but I'm gonna do them on my knees to start. Okay, I've got water. So always when we go on the ground, we go down. Round your nose to your knee, breathe. Come up to prepare, get extension. Feel the imbalances and just correct them just by a pelvic tilt, tuck, shoulders back, lengthen from the belly button, look ahead. Remember those cues through the day. Your shoulders aren't earrings. Engage the ab. Good, nice. And jump back. That's how we go. Okay, nice. Now come to the top of the toes. I mean top of the knees. And drop. Breathe. A little bit of cobra. Look up as you push up. Look left. Look right. Nice. Push back. Child pose just for a second. Nice. Okay, so walkouts, push-ups. It's an awesome body weight thing to do, and there's all kinds of ways to do it. One of these is, let's do, so come onto hands and knees, right? Be on your tippy toes or the top of your foot. Now I want you to walk your hands out to a push-up, a girl push-up, right? So it's 1, 2, 3. See that little extra pull? Feet are together or cross, and then now push back, 2, 3. Right? So now it's 1, 2, 3. Now, my hands, if you notice, aren't right under my shoulders, which I always preach. What I'm trying to get is extension. So you go 1, 2, 3. 1 and 2. Right? Make it as challenging. Don't compromise your shoulders, but just work on getting extension. Right? In here, you're not hiking your shoulders, squeezing your shoulders. It's your abs. Abs. Challenge your abs even more by dropping your knees down, your feet down to the ground. Right? So here they're up. As we come forward, drop them. And just watch that change. Actually, let's do that for 5. And stay with your arms here under your shoulders. 3, 2, 1. Okay, now step up on, extend your right leg and lift your weight. Extend the left leg and lift your weight and then hold. See it? Breathe. 1, 2. So come in, breathe, back. This could be our lower body walkout, and I just broke it like that just to kind of prepare your core for the act, for the move we were gonna be doing. Nice. This is just a gentle walkout for your abs. Okay. Good, nice. Now, ready? We're gonna do both, and we're not gonna walk out, we're just gonna extend at the same time. So get your hands wider than you longer than you normally would, right? Because I want them. So come out, your shoulders are here, come out a foot in front. Nice, come onto your tippy toes. Now you're gonna lift your body, you're gonna extend and move forward. Breathe, hold, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice, now crouch back down, right? So let's make that active. And let's crouch out, extend out and crouch in 5 times. It's hard. If it's hard for you, don't come onto your feet. Go forward, keep your knees on the ground. Come back. It's that small. Small is good. Slow is good. Okay? Now here, 1, 2. If it's not challenging enough, get your arms even wider. 3. It's small. 4, 5. Now don't drop your knees to the ground. Little crouch. Extend. Little crouch. Push down. Grab the floor with your fingers. Four more. This is challenging. Three. Two. One. Nice. Drop. Whoo, child pose.
Gorgeous.
So thread the needle. Take your right hand, turn your palm up and bring it through. Drop your shoulder to the ground, keeping your heels low. Rotate, look up, breathe. Come back to the center. That's a good core challenge right there. Walkouts, knee walkouts, girl push up. Oh, we'll come up with a name. Nice,
good.
Dead bug two more times. Thread the needle, sorry. Nice. Whoa. Just for the fun of it, give me a little bit of a camel. Not a back bend, right? Camel's not a, it is a back bend. It's not a lean back. It is a back bend. Yeah, nice. Reach for the top of the heels, for behind your knees. You want to try to keep your shoulders over the hips as you arch your body forward and reach your hands back. Just do it a few times. Feels really good. Okay, nice. All right, so hopefully you have a wall nearby. If you don't have a wall, get a block or a weight. You can use weights, right? Weights, whatever. What I want to do is an L set on the wall and just help our bodies learn how to lift your body up. It's hard, all right? It's a hard thing. Okay, so get your feet or whatever, get it near your feet, because I'm going to show you a tabletop transition just so that you can see how you swing your body a little, right? So get on, sit down, your feet face forward, your knees are hip width apart. Bring your heels as close to your butt as you can tolerate. Fingertips can be in, fingertips can be out. Lift, lengthen, and align. You're not rounded, okay? You're at a really good boat angle, because when you come up into tabletop, your table has to be balanced enough that I could put a hot teapot on your belly and you could hold it without the water spilling, all right? So then I want you to go down and transition back to an L sit. Come up and back. Up. Up. Go back. So see how I'm just dropping? That's okay to do that. Real people can do it without their butt dropping to the ground. Real strong people. I'm going to show you using weights or blocks with the upper body, not the lower, right? Forward, back, up. All right, so you see I come through, my body engages, my core is rounded. My feet, try it with your feet flexed. Up and pointed. Nice. Okay, that was five. You can also do it. This is weird though, I don't think I can do it with this weight, I'm sorry. But if you have blocks, your feet can be on it and you can do it. Or, you can just practice pushing your feet and put your hands however you feel comfortable to do this, because it's weird at first. Nice. Right? Try your fists. You know, when you have compromised wrists like I do, you have to figure out a way to do what you want to do with your body. Maybe I do it with the weight. If your wrists are annoyed, especially if you downhilled yesterday, holding on for whatever reason and lifting your body up is easier, right? And you have to find where it's going to be easy. You have to find the distance. You have to find where the fulcrum of your body is. So it might take you 10 times to figure out what, where you have to position all your extremities so that you can move your body the way that you want it to move, so that you can engage the muscle groupings that you want to strengthen. Does that make sense? It's not always mindless. But so here, right? So I need to get a little closer. This is where I'm going to do a strength hold. Two. Nice. That's it for me right there. Four, five, six, seven. My legs are just touching. They're at full extension. But see? Beautiful. Ooh, nice. That actually felt really good. So do a nice little reach. Head to knee pose. We're going to do it again. We're going to do it two more times. So if you can't, if you don't have a wall and you have, are putting your foot on something, right? Maybe I'll do it like this. Just a little awkward. Right, I'll just do one side, but here. See? It's one, two. It's the same thing. My arm's a little more forward, all right? And if that is hard for you, but you want to push up, you could just do this tabletop to a sit, and then you lift, engage. So here you can hold this, 10, 9, 8. Whatever it is for the strength of this, if this is what you need to strengthen, strengthen here. If you want to make it a little more challenging, you can come to extended legs. But hold this, 10, 9. And if you want to do an L sit right up off the ground, do that and hold it up to 10. All right? Nice. Now transition through. Let's do another, at least 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Whew, right? So that can be the transition that you hold. Just practicing this is, all right? So even this, put the heels on the ground, your knees bent. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice. So just for the fun of it, stretch your wrists. Nice. I like to come to the top of my wrist, the top of my hand, get it flat. Nice, gorgeous. There, and then rotate the palms in. So you're not in the fingertips. You're not doing the fingertips and it's bent. The top here is what I want on the ground. So if you have to bend your arms and be a little hunched back initially, all right, you do that. Then you straighten the elbow. Then you bring your body weight equally over it. For me, I've got to rotate my inside of my elbow in a little bit, and it's a nice wrist stretch. And then rotate your wrist away from you, and then do it with a fist, and even rotate to the outside, open, and then come back. Nice. And then push down, open your fingers, get them equal. Notice, do you keep your two middle fingers, the middle finger and the ring finger? A lot of people with compromised wrist, trigger thumb, or carpal tunnel, the middle finger and the ring finger won't separate. Okay, so make them all open, equal. Push through the butt of the hand, palm, as well as the fingertips and the fingers, and then push your arms straight. Full extension, and get your ear away from your shoulder. Nice. We'll do it on the other side. So start. Either or whatever. Here, fingertips, get that. Work immediately on proper alignment. Right, nice, good. Extend, come forward, and then rotate back. And watch where your arm wants to bend and when. Nice. So come up to the fingertips, roll it around. Come to the top of the hand now. Fingertips face away. Your thumb is on the ground too. Rotate it out. And then come in, fingertips face towards the feet. Nice, and play with the angle. See, right there, trying to move my body a little forward and bend. My finger comes up, my elbow wants to bend. That's the part of the handstand that I struggle in too. So it's interesting. Yep, so make it work nice. Ooh, beautiful. All right, there you go. So L-sit for your abs. The workout is a really good core too. And thank you for joining me. Namaste. Have an awesome day, and I will see you again next Tuesday.